I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock. Hey guys, so today's video is a little bit different than any video I've done before, and I'm super excited about it. I've been seeing a lot of these videos popping up all over YouTube, and I wanted to make my own version of it because I'm someone that suffers really badly during that time of the month. So I definitely wanted to share some hacks and also things you can do to alleviate the annoying symptoms associated with having your period and like ways that you can really just pamper yourself. So I hope you guys will enjoy this video. If you do, please give it a big thumbs up so that I know that you enjoyed it, and then I know what kinds of videos you'd like to see in the future. Also, if you're not already, don't forget to subscribe so you can be updated every time I post a new video. And without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first hack or tip is to take ibuprofen a couple days beforehand, because what ibuprofen does is it reduces the hormone responsible for creating your cramps and reduce the severity of your cramps. They say if you take Advil or ibuprofen after your period starts, it's too late. Although it is effective, it's not as effective as if you took it a few days before. It's the way you move, it's the way you move. So the next tip or life hack is actually one that most of us already know, but not many of us actually do, and that is to exercise. When you exercise, you increase your blood circulation and you produce beta endorphins. So the blood circulation actually physically reduces your cramps because it pushes the blood through the areas where there's already constriction, and then the endorphins dull the pain from the hormone that actually causes your cramps. So some great exercises you could do would be something like yoga, which is great because it releases tension and relieves stress on top of increasing your blood flow. You could also do some brisk walking or even some light aerobics. So for me personally, the main reasons I don't like to work out on my period is because A, I can usually feel my tampons and I find them a little bit uncomfortable, especially when doing things like yoga. And B, I am terrified of leaks. So there are actually tampons that have been designed for athletic purposes, and for consideration, Tampax sent me their Pearl Active tampons, which are slimmer than regular tampons, so they're more comfortable to use when you're doing any kind of athletic activity, but they're still as absorbent as regular tampons, so you don't have to worry about leaks. Don't let this be our final song. So my next tip or hack is using a hot water bottle or a heating pad. And I'm actually gonna show you guys here how I made a DIY version. So all I did was I took a thick fuzzy sock and I added in a couple cups of dry white rice and just tied off the end. And then you put it in the microwave for a couple of minutes. I did mine for 4 minutes, but if you have a really strong microwave, maybe you want to do 3. So how it works is it reduces the contractions of your muscles, and it also increases blood circulation because it warms up the area. So if you have not tried this yet, it will change your life. I'm only human, can't you see? I made a mistake. So my next tip is more for pampering yourself, and that is to relax and just do something that you enjoy. So for me, it's really nice to just relax and listen to some soft music, especially when we're on our periods. Sometimes we're just extra emotional and we want to watch a sappy love movie or listen to some soothing soft music. So I highly recommend looking up a playlist on Spotify that suits that criteria. I actually looked up period playlist, not expecting to find much, but ended up finding an amazing playlist with some of my favorite songs over the last like decade. Outside, for angels to fly. So another thing that might sound strange but actually really works is ASMR. ASMR is super soothing and it actually helps people with insomnia fall asleep. So if you put on some ASMR, it gets you into a super relaxed state and just calms you so that you don't have as many contractions in your uterus, which causes your cramps. I'm falling on my knees, forgive me, I'm a fucking fool. So the next hack or tip is great for all you chocolate lovers out there. Dark chocolate actually has high levels of magnesium, and studies have been proven that if you increase your magnesium around that time of the month, then it really helps alleviate your cramps. So to kill two birds with one stone, I got some dark chocolate covered almonds. Almonds are also really high in magnesium, so you can eat them on their own even if you don't like chocolate. and that will also boost your magnesium. Feeling the sun, party done, shadows walking home. My next tip might be an obvious one, but it's definitely worth mentioning, and that is to take a bath. So to help me relax, I like lighting a couple of candles and breaking apart a bubble bar. This is my favorite bubble bar from Lush, and it makes your bath water so beautiful and shimmery. Baths actually treat your cramps physically because the warm water actually helps with your blood flow, but you can also add in Epsom salt, which is actually magnesium sulfate. So when you add in a few cups into your bath water, it dissolves and gets penetrated through your skin. So then it actually gives your body a boost of magnesium, and not only does it reduce your cramps, but it also relieves muscle tension and muscle pain as well. So my next hack is how to get rid of bloating and cramps at the same time. So what you can do is you can drink peppermint or chamomile tea. Both of these are caffeine free, so they won't make your cramps worse. And on top of that, peppermint tea actually reduces muscle spasms, it's a muscle relaxant, and it increases your blood flow. And chamomile tea is an anti-inflammatory, so it actually reduces the hormone responsible for making your cramps to begin with. So if you don't want to take ibuprofen or any kind of medication, then this is great. On top of this, both teas are great for reducing bloating, so it will help get rid of that extra water retention. I hope that I can turn back the time to make it all right. So another way to pamper yourself and relax while relieving your cramps at the same time is by using lavender. Lavender is super soothing and it helps relieve tension. So it helps you relax and just kind of feel more at ease, and it's been scientifically proven to help reduce cramps. One of my favorite things to use is the chamomile and lavender bath and body work spray that just really helps soothe and relax me, especially before bed. So if you're looking for a way to de-stress and relax, then I highly recommend lavender. It really helps your stress just kind of melt away. And I find that it works really well if you want to lay down, have some TV on or some Netflix and watch your favorite show and just be in a nice calming environment. And if you need a TV show recommendation, just throwing it out there that they have all 10 seasons of Friends on Netflix. So that is my favorite show to binge watch. So my last tip or hack is how to have a better sleep at night. And if you're anything like me, then when you have your period, it's the most uncomfortable thing. No position you get in is comfortable, and you're tossing and turning, and that can really throw off your sleeping cycle. So one thing that really helps me is taking melatonin. Melatonin is something that your body produces naturally after the sun starts to set. So taking it before bed when you're uncomfortable on your period can really help you keep your sleeping cycle on schedule, and you won't wake up feeling worse in the morning from cramps and a lack of sleep. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and let me know in the comment section below what kinds of videos you guys would like to see, because I love when you guys give me input. So I hope you're all doing well, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye guys. Live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if there was no past. Doing it all night, all summer.